In today's society, we are constantly on the move. It is hard to find time after work and school to prepare meals that are healthy, that are nutritious, tasty, and that won't break your pocketbook. In today's episode, we will discuss healthier food options, their fun, unique flavors that can be prepared in every home. We will also discuss the key to establishing a fundamental culture in the kitchen and its importance to establishing a healthier lifestyle. Please explain how you personally got involved with health and with wellness.
So I personally became involved with health and wellness because I got to a point actually in my work life where I was just really frustrated. I started to do a search for culinary schools that were health oriented, that were health supportive, not just creating this beautiful dish, but how to create food that really transformed your health. Being in New York City, you're just surrounded by food and institutions. So I found the Natural Gourmet Institute for Health and Culinary Arts. I became certified as a holistic health coach and just kind of snowballed into this bigger thing of me reaching out and affecting change in a bigger way.
When I see produce, when I see fruits, when I see vegetables, what is it I should look for when selecting each item to include in my meal?
That's an awesome question. So when you are selecting produce, the best thing to do, you're going to use your senses. You're going to look, are there vibrant, fresh colors? Greens need to be green, not yellow. And you want to make sure on greens, it's a nice, sturdy, you know, texture. It's not wilted, right? When looking for root vegetables, see, root vegetables are tricky because they are very sturdy vegetables. And people think, oh, they're going to look crazy anyways. Let me just grab one. No. Again, you're looking for the feeling. Is it nice and tough? Like a carrot shouldn't be all soggy and pliable, right? It should be able to break. So you're looking for things like that. A fresh color, smell it, pick it up. So, of course, when we're shopping for produce, we're looking for colors because those are antioxidants. So when you see a lot of green, you're getting chlorophyll, right? You see the oranges, you're getting the carotenoids, like from the plantain, from the carrot, from the butternut squash, that orange color. So everything has value. You know, it's just not frivolous why things look the way they do.
Ms. Allen, you mentioned organic.
Yes.
So what is it that organic foods provide in terms of our shopping experience and our meals that regular produce doesn't provide? What exactly is the organic food experience?
The better question is, what does it not have, right? So the difference between conventional versus organic produce is that the conventional produce will be produced in a way that has agricultural chemicals, synthetic fertilizers, synthetic insecticides, synthetic pesticides, right? It's going to be, unfortunately, also genetically modified organisms. So that's going to be in that category. Now, organic, when you talk about produce, does not have synthetic fertilizers, not have synthetic insecticides or pesticides. And also practices are going to be put in place of how this produce is grown in the field. I wanted to really keep diabetics in mind when I was thinking of these three dishes, and not just diabetics, because if you're not diabetic, you can totally enjoy this and get benefit and, you know, and really want to make it again for yourself. Because did I mention it was delicious? Yeah, it's delicious. So here we go. We have a wonderful kale dish that I will be showing how to make it. Basically, the kale is sliced thin so we can saute it. That's the magic of quickly cooking your greens, saute. So we have some sauteed kale with onion, tomato, garlic, plantain, and codfish. So, All right, good. So I'm hearing slight sizzle there.
So what is the significance of coconut oil in combination with the onion and the garlic and the oils?
Yeah, so coconut oil is actually one of those really, really good oils that has been given a bad rap, unfortunately, because it's a saturated fat. So saturated fat has been demonized here stateside because of some people's opinion that it can cause heart disease, but see, all saturated fat aren't the same. This saturated fat is from a plant-based food. So this saturated fat, coconut oil, is actually called like a miracle oil in some communities. There's tons of books, tons of research that shows that traditionally for hundreds of years, coconut oil has been so beneficial to health. So coconut oil is antifungal. It's actually, it aids you in losing weight because of the type of fat that it is. You know, it's a middle chain triglyceride. That's like the fancy term, but really what that does is help your body release excess fat. So coconut oil, not only is it awesome for flavor, but it's so beneficial to your health.
It has a unique aroma as well. So we're about to add the garlic in the oils.
And, yeah.
How does this complement the kale and the plantain? What is it that, you know, we can expect to taste from the aroma and the combination of flavors?
Honestly, what you can expect is just a nice symphony in your mouth, a nice marriage of flavors. And see, this is what helps, you know, you have a pleasant experience is, you know, you can kind of detect this flavor from that, this spice, that herb, that aroma. When you have those different, you know, items all coming together, it's so great. So next, after we have woken up basically the natural sweetness and the flavors of the garlic and the onion, I'm gonna put in the plantain. So the plantain, again, you're getting that sweet element. As you cook it, it's gonna start to become nice, more yellow color, and blending it with the garlic and onion is gonna bring that sweetness out even more. So I'm gonna add the kale, but before I do that, I'll put just a little bit of our really good quality sea salt here. So I'm adding kale, and I'm gonna just stir it around so that it gets coated real nice by the garlic, the onion, the coconut oil. And you can hear it cracking a bit more. That's because there's water content in the kale. So as that water hits the oil, there's a bit of a pop that you can hear. All right. I'm just gonna put the top on and let this steam and plate it up when it's done. All right, so that's that. A yogurt fruit parfait. So I'm gonna take some plain yogurt and really sweeten it up with a natural sweetener that is definitely diabetic friendly, and be adding some awesome, wholesome flavorings in it. Roasted sweet potato. Yes, with fresh rosemary.
A healthier diet is key to establishing a healthier lifestyle. The key to maintaining balance between our daily lives and developing healthier lifestyles is found within an important place within our homes, our kitchens. Whether you are venturing to try something new or establishing a new routine to move towards better health, the food we eat and how it is prepared begins within our hearts, our minds, and our homes.